Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin.
Good morning, folks. Day number 47 of constant rain all over the globe, and experts are now saying it may never end. Here at WLN News, we're wondering, what if it never stopped raining? Man, if only some show could explain this.
Here on this blocky planet, it's been pouring for over a month, and it's wreaking havoc on society. Schools and hospitals are flooded, entire cities are without power, and we can't get where we need to go. Wait, animator, don't you control the weather here? Huh, well, can't argue with that. But besides the obvious, what are other implications of this never-ending rain? These massive downpours will have detrimental effects on plants, crops, and trees all over the world. The destruction of these plants impacts everything from food supplies to the amount of oxygen we have to breathe. As you know, plants absorb CO2 and convert it into breathable oxygen through a process called photosynthesis. About 30% of our oxygen comes from terrestrial plants, but when the soil is soaked to the point of no return and sunlight is continuously blocked by clouds, plants can't get the nutrients they need to photosynthesize. This will kill the plants and leave more CO2 and less oxygen in the atmosphere. And without sunlight, the phytoplankton in the sea that currently provide over 50% of our oxygen will die off too. Anyway, less plants means less food. Many crops and livestock can't handle the extreme rain, so the amount of food we can produce will dwindle. I have a feeling this means we'll be eating a lot of rice, since it grows in fields of water. Sushi, anyone? Oh, okay, I guess not. Well, we'd probably want to avoid fish anyway, since extreme downpours like this flood pollutants into lakes, rivers, and local water supplies. These pollutants can range from sewage to heavy metals, and they harm marine life and contaminate our drinking water. This contamination can cause some pretty serious health issues. Dirty water can lead to hepatitis A, cholera, and typhoid fever. None of which sounds fun. Or is fun. Plus, instances of malaria, dengue, and yellow fever all increase with floods and influxes of mosquitoes. And don't forget about all the mold that's undoubtedly growing in all of the flooded homes. Well, what about poor Mother Earth? How will she handle all this rain? Spoiler alert, not well. Torrential downpours like this cause horrendous deadly landslides all over the world. Landslides come in the form of rockfalls, mudslides, and basically any other form of earth falling down a slope. These can block roads, affect communication, and take down power lines. And these are just the effects of normal landslides. Who knows how bad they'll be if it literally never stops raining. But the natural disasters don't end there. It's been found that rain-induced erosion can loosen underground rocks along fault lines, contributing to earthquakes. Now, this may be just a hypothetical situation, but global warming is worsening rainfall extremes and shifting weather patterns. We all need to make changes in our everyday lives to combat global warming and help ward off horrible scenarios like this. I don't know about you, but I would much rather bask in the sun. Oh, hey look, it's back. That's weird. Let us know what we should talk about next in the comment section below. Curious to know what would happen if the Earth ran out of food and water? Check out this video. So much of the groundwater we use is lost to evaporation or ends up in the oceans, meaning it doesn't get reused. And that's leaving billions of people without clean water. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.